But you probably noticed something there that's quite normal. Everybody is on their smartphone. And I think, you know, if you have a look back, I think this time 2 years ago, smartphones were a real rarity. And now they're interwoven into pretty much everything we do. A colleague of mine sort of summed up how we use mobile phones as being something that, you know, we use phones to entertain ourselves or kill time, save time, or share moments in time. And I think this is a classic example of that. We've now reached something like 51% smartphone penetration in the UK. An extraordinary, another extraordinary fact is that almost 60% of us are using the mobile web on a daily basis. So, you know, when you look back from this presentation, you go home, just look back from your personal device. I'm sure many of you will be catching up on email, be looking at Facebook, looking at the Twitter feed. Look up from your personal device and see how many other people are encapsulated and entwined into this small device that's so occupying their world. However, what does it mean for your business? I think that's the big challenge. All these big stats, kind of you lose wood for the trees. I was at a dinner last night and a marketing director said, look, I'm just confused by the technology. The technology is preventing me from really reaching out and engaging with consumers. This is about the basics of what I do, but I can't get past the jargon. Please explain it to me. I think that's a problem lots of people have. So just like Velti have done, what we have done is put all of our global research in one place. So I really encourage you to go and have a look at this on our mobile planet. So this covers about 79 different markets. Really looks at in-depth insights that we've gleaned from what consumers are doing. So, you know, I thought it was mentioned earlier on that we don't share enough. So this is our effort to share more. So I encourage you to go have a look at that. I think, you know, if I can just take some things that I found interesting, I'm sure you'll find different things interesting in this research, was how we use these devices. So it's well known that these devices are incredibly social. But the stat I picked up was that 28% of us check our social networking before we get out of bed. That just shows you the blurs between offline and online are now merging. For many people, you know, it's something that they just do, this idea of connectivity being our lifeblood, something that we just cannot do without. And indeed, I think there's a syndrome called nomophobia, the fear of losing your mobile phone. And we've all experienced that. You know, if you're running out of battery, you know, feel disconnected, disassociated with what's going on in the world. I think it was mentioned in the previous presentation, these are incredible entertainment devices. You know, if we have a look just at our platform, YouTube, we've seen 600 million video views a day coming through mobile devices. That's almost 10% of our global traffic on YouTube. I think that's tripled since 2011. That's tripled. Another thing that a retailer was mentioning earlier on, we've got 150 days approximately to Christmas. Think what's going to happen in that space of time. There's probably going to be another big phone launch by a big consumer electronics manufacturer. I'm sure you can guess what that would be. Just think of the knock-on effect that will have for smartphone proliferation. You know, there'll be new price points. People will be passing on their old device to their children, to their wife, to their family. So again, that increases the penetration of mobile phones and how it's going to affect us. I think also another thing that touched on was, if we have a look at the game, Draw Something, how many of you played that game? So quite a few people. Now, obviously, that's a huge success story for the guys personally involved. But what really got me was that reached over 1 million users in just 9 days. So mobile phones can give businesses a sense of scale very, very quickly. And the third thing I picked up from this research was that these devices really help us make sense of the world around us. If we can react instantly to stimulus. So, for example, TV ads. 58% of UK smartphone owners use search after seeing a TV ad. So as marketeers, you think about how that changes your media mix and how you're influencing people. They also act as our local companion and guide, sort of our mini brain in our pocket, probably a bigger brain than we're carrying on our head. We're seeing about 1 in 3 mobile searches having local intent, as opposed to, I think, the stat is about 1 in 5 from desktop. So it's a very different kind of search. And also 84% of users, 78% of people, when they do a local search, take action, whether that's visiting a business, calling it, or even buying from that business. And I think this idea of mobile and mobile and proximity to business, as marketeers will devote a lot more focus and deliver unmatched relevance. So with all these big shifts in society and really how the mobile and web-connected devices are changing it, I thought, how would I best sort of talk to you guys in sort of the 15 minutes that I've got to speak? I know it's 10, but I'm already overrunning. So I thought, you know, these are the four questions that I think businesses that are succeeding in this area have answered. And I think, you know, they're crucial for you to progress. And not progressing means that you're going to be left behind. You know, we're really at an inflection point. The genie is out of the bottle. People are only going to do more of this activity. And it's new consumer behavior. So, you know, really pay attention to answering these things. The first is, how does mobile change my value proposition? How does mobile change my web presence? Is our organization adapting to mobile quick enough? And then lastly, so the area I specialize in, how should I adapt our marketing to mobile? So the first question, how does it change your value proposition? I guess the easiest way to look at this is, what is your customer doing already? Have you analyzed the analytics on your site around the traffic you're getting from mobile devices? Do you understand what your consumer is wanting from you? There's a number of different ways. Often people think, right, this is a real moment that I can have an emotive moment or connection with my client or advertiser, or consumer. If we have a look at retail, smartphones are not just changing the way that people find your business, they change what you do in store. You know, I think the CEO of Walmart called this the new era of price transparency. And almost 50% of smartphone users are using their phone in store to compare prices. Check out, can I get it cheaper? I remember, you know, in a previous conversation this morning, it must be really heartbreaking for people in there to get a client, consumer in, he checks the price, go, yeah, I love this, and then buys it, perhaps from Amazon or another retailer, and walks out the store. This idea of showrooming is really changing the face of retail, I think, and it's only going to get more. A recent study in the States called sort of pointed out that around about 40% of walkouts from stores happened as a result of a decision people make on their smartphone. So how can businesses change their value proposition in stores? So I think, you know, a good example of one that has changed their value proposition is Oasis. You know, they've installed iPads into store. Their crucial insight is people hate waiting. So why do they have to wait when they can buy straight from the iPad? I think they also offer, you know, delivery within 90 minutes. And around 20% of their total in-store sales are now through these devices. Another approach could be offering unique bundles. Can you work with the guys you work with to make apple to apple comparisons mute? Can you offer something that's special? It might even just be as simple as making sure your salespeople are really educated. Although, be warned, probably about 73% of mobile-powered shoppers prefer to get their information from their smartphone rather than from a sales guy. So, you know, that's something to consider about. And I look around businesses that are doing well in this. Who's seen that Moonpig advert for video cards? Anybody seen that? Well, you will do. I think that's a fantastic way of thinking about how to change your value proposition. Barclay card with Ping It, another great way of establishing, you know, new relationships by taking advantage of something that we do every day. You know, you go for a curry and a few beers and watch the football, your mate goes, oh, well, I want, that's 20 quid. It's instantaneous and really taking advantage of that. And obviously it's Google, we're constantly innovating in this space to match up with what consumers demand from us. And that's constantly changing. You know, things like voice search, Google search, local search, and my recent favorite, which is called Google Chrome, have you for mobile. If you haven't downloaded it to your Android device, I encourage you to do. Obviously, I'm paid to encourage you to do so. But it's fantastic, the Omnibox. But what's really good is it's synced with all my devices. So all my bookmarks from my desktop are now married to my mobile device, I'm married to my tablet. I can continue reading something that I was looking at my desktop on my mobile phone. And all of my history is saved. That's something that's just seamless and something that consumers really expect. The second question that I think you should be asking yourselves, how does it change your digital destinations? I think that there's been a lot of talk about how brands should do that. I think, you know, it's crazy, as some of the stats talking earlier on, the majority of UK businesses don't have a mobile website. If you don't have one, then this is the number one priority I think you should do. Why? Well, because around about 57% of users won't recommend your business if you have a poorly designed website experience. I think, you know, the idea that we talk often at Google is winning the moments that matter, and mobile moments are critical. You know, this is probably a zero moment of truth where you have that opportunity to tip that person over into making a decision, whether it's making a decision to buy your product or to recommend that product further on. And it's got to be different. I think, you know, lots of retailers think in the way of the good way to put it for retailers, but also lots of other brands, is if you've got a big flagship store, it doesn't stock the same things as a pop-up store. It doesn't stock the same things as a store on the street. They have very different purposes. So you've got to start thinking about your mobile way and mobile site from the point of view of the consumer. Now, the third question, and also if you want to have a look at how your mobile site performs currently, another way we're sharing data is on Getmo. If you go and have a look that up, you can have a look how your site appears to a mobile consumer, and also download some reports about the performance of your site in terms of speed and in terms of reliability as well. The third question I think you should be asking yourselves is your organization adapting to mobile quick enough? You know, can you point to someone and say, this is the guy who's responsible for mobile strategy in our organization? Does that person have enough clout within the organization at boardroom level to convince the business to move faster and quicker in this space? For us, obviously, it's been Eric Schmidt for a long time. He said that we're a mobile-first company. I think whatever business division we're in, we have to overinvest our time in mobile because we know mobile is critical for our future. Finally, how should you adapt your marketing to mobile? And I guess this is a key question when you think about how to interact with consumers and what the experience is like for a consumer trying to connect with your business. Naturally, we think that all advertisers should embrace mobile search, the idea of connecting with a consumer whilst they're in the physical world looking for your products or services. But also just try and have a look for a few searches for your brand or your product on that search engine page on your mobile and see the experiences that they connect through to. How can you improve that? Are you happy about that? Have a look at what's going on in the wider business that you're involved in. Another thing, obviously, that you should be thinking about is how can you get reach through mobile advertising and in-app advertising. I know that Barry talked about that earlier on. That's an incredible way to get reach and engage with someone on such a personal device. So that's what, in summary, I wanted to talk to you about, those four key questions. But I wanted to leave you just a thought. And I want you all to take out your smartphone from your pocket. Just have a look at that device and think that is the slowest device you're ever going to own. They're only going to get quicker. They're only going to get better. They're only going to get more involved in your life from now on. As I said, the genie is out of the bottle. You cannot go back. So really make the most of this opportunity. Thanks very much.